观众朋友大家晚安，现在向大家介绍我们今天的嘉宾，他是代表中文投资网 Chinese Investment Company 的 Preston Hum 来到我们的节目当中。 Preston, welcome to my show.
Hi Lily, thanks for having me.
Say a few words to our San Francisco audience, please.
Hi, well, my name is Preston, and today I will be your ICO analyst, and I'm just going to kind of go over cryptocurrencies, blockchain, and initial coin offerings.
Okay, those are hot topics.
Sure.
Tell us about yourself, and what did you do before, and how did you get into the cryptocurrency market?
Sure, so I originally started as a data analyst at Hyundai Motor of America, and I worked there for about 4 years, but during the end of my time, I had a friend that visited me one night, and I know it sounds like a fairy tale, but it really happened. He ended up talking to me about cryptocurrencies, blockchain technology, and initial coin offerings. Mm-hmm. And at that point, I really only knew about like Bitcoin and stuff like that from that whole incident with the 2013 Silk Road. Mm-hmm. And if you aren't familiar with that, or people aren't familiar with that, it was an online marketplace that used Bitcoin to use as transactions for like illicit activities. So it was like drugs, guns, and everybody was like afraid of it because, you know, you couldn't trace and stuff like that.
Right.
But that's actually not true. But anyways, when he told me about that, I wanted to invest my first Bitcoin, and I did. So that was last year, and then I got in my first ICO. So now I'm an ICO analyst here.
Wow. Talking about the enthusiasm and this market attraction, I think it gives you a lot of effect. Mm-hmm. Tell us, why do you think the cryptocurrency and the blockchain industry is so important?
Sure. So when people think of Bitcoin, you can't really think about Bitcoin without thinking about the financial crisis of 2008. Mm. And that was a huge problem with centralized financial institutions. And after that, people wanted something that was fast, secure, and you know, like borderless, permissionless, and trustless. And what that really just means is that there's no borders to this coin. Like, anybody can trade. It's a global currency. Permissionless means that you don't need something, some entity to tell you whether or not you can use it. And trustless meaning that you know once you do X, you will get Y. Okay. So the reason why cryptocurrencies are so important is that the regular financial institutions, like fiat money and stuff like that, they're not really backed by anything. Essentially, what people understand about it is that you can print more money, right? And that's bad for the economy.
Right.
And it creates inflation.
Dilute the value.
Sure. I mean, Bitcoin has its own hyperinflation and deflationary values as well, but not going to go into that. But it does have what's behind it, which is blockchain technology. Mm. And I'm actually really passionate about blockchain technology because it solves a lot of problems that we don't realize that we had. Like, when you think about the hacks with Equifax, like one of the biggest hacks in, you know, like financial history, right?
Right.
Hundreds of millions of customers' data that was breached. Or you think about hospitals that are taken for ransom for the data. It happens all the time. Even, I think, Sachs, Lord & Taylor, like, right?
Right, right.
Have you heard about that?
Yeah, recently.
Yeah, so all these data breaches are...
5 million customers were affected.
Exactly. But blockchain basically makes it so that the data is decentralized and distributed. So instead of having one area of attack, you need to hack thousands or millions.
Right.
So I think that's really important. And even if you don't like cryptocurrencies, you need to like blockchain, because that's not the if. That's going to be the when.
For the future.
It is the future.
Okay. And you mentioned about the initial coin offering. Mm-hmm. What is it? It refers to ICO.
Right.
Well, in connection with the IPO even.
Yeah, so initial coin offering is also known as a TGE, or token generated event. Mm. And the way it's similar to an IPO is that it's a way for companies to get funding. But traditionally, IPOs are generally expensive. They are rigorous, but they could cost companies for up to like $750K or $1 million to go public. And that's expensive. A lot of these new companies in this space don't have that kind of capital already, you know, right? So ICOs are initial coin offerings. And what they do is they allow companies to get funding through the sale of their tokens. Mm-hmm. And the reason why initial coin offerings are important is because these tokens facilitate the system. And the systems of blockchain only work if there's people using it. So the question is basically, how do you get people to use a system that already requires people to use the system? Mm-hmm. And you have to have coins that appreciate in value as the use and utility of these tokens increase as well.
I understand. Okay, are there any particular project in your pipeline you think is worth it?
Right, so when you think about like these, what are solid projects, you wanna look at a couple of things. But for me, I really like Ethereum, mainly because it's core competitor to Bitcoin in the fact that Bitcoin is usually known as just a traditional currency, right? Mm. But Ethereum has a lot of utility. And what it does is what's called smart contracts. And if you aren't familiar with
smart contract.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's basically like...
versus a dumb contract?
Well, I mean, I probably signed a lot of dumb contracts, but just kidding. Yeah, it's like a vending machine. You know, when you put something in, you expect something out. You know, you don't, there's no debate whether or not you're going to get a soda if you put a dollar in that machine. Mm-hmm. So Ethereum actually paved the way for a lot of these initial coin offerings, and that's one of the things I really like. Now, Ethereum's price is not that good right now, but there are other competing projects, and there's three other ones that I really like, which is like EOS, Neo, mm-hmm. and Icon, and mm-hmm. they all are platform coins, which means that there's going to be decentralized applications that are built on that platform. Mm. So when the bear market happens, usually those are the last ones to go, but the first ones to rise again.
Mm. Okay, I think at this point, a lot of investors in the Chinese community, they think why decentralized is such a good thing to go. We won't get into that also. What do you look at when you decide whether if it's a good ICO or not?
Okay, yeah, so there are four kind of key points I like to look at, and the first one is the white paper, and that's just basically...
White paper.
Yeah, and that's just basically telling you what kind of, what the coin does, what problems are they trying to solve, how are they going to solve it, and how are they going to execute it.
Mm.
So that's really important, and a lot of white papers, they actually, that's what a lot of the valuation is based on, even though there isn't no like working product already. The second is like marketing partnerships, and I think that's important because you want to have strategic partnerships and you want to market correctly. And sometimes marketing doesn't suit you as well because the product development isn't done yet. Partnerships as well, some companies fabricate their partnerships, some people exaggerate their partnerships.
Mm.
It's good to look at. The third is token distribution and just kind of how the companies disperse their tokens, how do they use the tokens, you know, what is that funding for?
Mm-hmm.
The last one is the community. And the community is kind of broad, but specific at the same time, because the broad part is, what is the general consensus on certain coins and stuff like that? And then within that community, there's a sub-community, you know? This is a very grassroots movement.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of the news is like, once you hear it on like big news sites like CNBC or Bloomberg, that might already be too late. You might already be behind the pack.
Oh, okay. So you're suggesting people really have to get into early.
Sure, early, and also, you know, cross-reference and make sure that just because you don't hear it on big news, like big news networks, doesn't mean it's not true.
Mm.
And if you hear these news and you see that you've checked and you see that it's valid, you might actually be ahead of the pack. So it's important to be in these communities.
I see. Okay. How do investors get into the ICOs? In other words, how can they choose it, or how can people make money off their own investment?
Well, there are about just three main points. I mean, every coin probably could have a different process, but the usual process, because most of the coins are made with on the Ethereum network, it goes like this. So the first, you have to whitelist. And when you whitelist, it just basically means like an intent to register.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like if anyone's listening that's, you know, applied to college, you have an intent to register. That's all it is, you know, saying that, oh, you're going to get in this coin. After that, you get some instructions saying that you might need to submit a KYC or AML.
Mm-hmm.
And if people aren't familiar with that, it just means know your customer, anti-money laundering. And the company just needs to know where that money is coming from. And, you know, they don't want terrorists investing in their coins, right?
Of course not.
Yeah, and it's standard, too. Like, even in regular, like, IPOs, you need accredited investors that will have to submit a KYC. So same thing, that's pretty standard.
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, you need to have tokens that are compatible to Switch.
Ah.
So when I was referring to the smart contracts, that's all it is. So it's just basically submitting tokens that are ERC-20 compatible with the Switch of the tokens.
Uh-huh.
And what ERC-20 means is Ethereum Request for Comments 20. And it's just a six-step list of code that you need to satisfy for you to get your tokens back.
What happened if one makes a mistake?
It's lost forever.
Oh my goodness. Okay, 如果我们的观众朋友想要知道更多关于这种ICO 方面的资讯的话，大家可以加入这个网站，就叫做 newcoins168.com， 可以在这个上面知道好多好多 ICO 还有这个 cryptocurrency 方面的知识。好的，或者是加 Warren 王的 WeChat 的 ID 是 WarrenWayne2018。 我们暂时告一段落，精彩持续，进一段工商资讯，马上回来。